In this video, we're going to be making a loan class to handle some of the common repetitive tasks that are involved in loan analysis. All right, so when we're done, you're going to be able to import and use their class in your Python applications like this. Okay, and I'm going to make this code available from a link in the video description on GitHub. All right, so if we want to just see what some of the things it will be able to do are. Okay, so we're going to have to pass in a few parameters first, right? The interest rate, the term, and the amount of money we're borrowing. And then, yeah, we're going to be able to do some simple stuff, right? Like get a payment. All right, maybe you want a loan amortization table. All right, so it'll be able to do that. And it'll be able to show you a summary of the loan. Okay, and you know, if you don't like the summary I've come up with, you can add things to it. All right, and you can also see what happens if you pay a little bit extra every month. All right, and here I'm going to just add $100. All right, so by doing that, we reduced our initial term from 30 years to about 27. All right, so those are the kinds of things we're going to be able to do. And with that, I guess we can go ahead and get started writing this class. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is my imports. Okay, and I'll just let you know that you may have to install a couple of things, particularly date utils may not be installed, and also we're going to be using NumPy Financial. That may not be installed. So to install them, right, you could just open the terminal inside PyCharm, right, and then pip install. For example, date utils. All right, there's a few similarly named modules out there about date utilities. All right, so just make sure you get this one. All right, and then you would do the same thing for NumPy Financial if you need that. Okay, so here's all the extensions I'm going to be using. And then, right, we'll just go ahead and define our class. All right, and I'll start by writing a initializer. All right, and we're going to pass in a few variables. So the rate, term, and the loan amount. All right, and I'm going to add an additional variable here, which is the start. And I'm going to set it as a default for basically 30 days or the next month from today. All right, so I'll use date time. All right, and this is going to be the default, and I'm going to allow people to, or you may want to allow people to import their own dates. And as long as we express it as an ISO format, we're going to be able to do that. All right, this is about the easiest way to get this done. All right, so if it's started in the past or it's going to start in the future, somebody may want to input that. We're going to allow that flexibility. Okay, and then we'll just start assigning the class variables here. Okay, so that should be enough to get started, and we can start to take a look at how this is shaping up. So doesn't do anything here. What I'm going to do is put in a temporary sort of placeholder, and I'll call it with those values. All right, we'll say it started today, and then we'll just sort of print the payment out. That's about all we can do at this point. Okay, so there it is, about $2,130 if we have a loan like that. All right, I'm going to add another variable here because later when I do that summary, I'm going to convert this payment into a string. So I'll put that in here. All right, and I'll just make an F string of the payment. All right, so there is our initializer. All right, let me make one more change to that later. All right, but I need to first define a method before I can do that. And the method I'm going to define here is the one that will give us a amortization table. All right, so I'm going to call it the loan table. And I don't need to pass anything in because I have already initialized all the variables that I need. Inside here, right, what I'm going to do is make a few arrays and then combine them into a pandas data frame for the amortization table. Okay, so I will get my periods. And I just need to enumerate the start date out to the end date here. Okay, so this is going to end up being the index of our data frame. All right, I'm going to calculate the interest for each period. To do that, I'm going to use this interest payment function from NumPy Financial. Okay, this line of code's getting somewhat long. I'm going to put the loop part of it down here. Okay, I am going to do the same thing for principal. All right, and it's almost exactly the same code, so I'll just copy and paste it. All right, and instead of the I payment, it's going to be the principal payment from NumPy Financial. So thank you, NumPy Financial. Okay, so we'll start off with those three columns, and then I will define a local variable, call it table, and that will become a pandas data frame. And it'll have columns payment. All right, and that's just going to equal the loan payment. Okay, it'll have interest, right, which will be the interest comprehension from above. And it will have principal. Okay, likewise from the comprehension above. Okay, I need to add that index, so let me actually space this out a little differently. All right, make it a little bit more readable. Those are the columns, and then our index is going to equal the periods comprehension converted to a pandas date time. Okay, and then usually these amortization tables have sort of a running balance in them, so once we're done with that, I will add a balance column. All right, and that's going to also be based on what's happened in the principal column. All right, so I'm going to take our initial loan amount, right, and I'm going to subtract away from that for each row. All right, and I'll get the cumulative sum there. Okay, so that's our amortization table. Once we're done there, we're going to return it, and I will round it to two decimal places. All right, so this should get us within a couple of pennies pretty much everywhere at least. All right, otherwise we have a lot more precision than we need. Okay, so what I'm going to do here then is define that as a property. So I'm going to add here this table, and I'm going to call the loan table method on it. Okay, so we can just kind of confirm that I didn't make any mistakes there, and I'll run this again, and instead of the payment, we'll return the amortization table. Okay, so far so good. All right, and we can see that the interest actually didn't get rounded there, which is kind of interesting, but everything else did. All right. And down at the bottom here, yeah, we are actually paying the entire balance down to zero. All right, so next we will sort of move on and add another method here. And it doesn't really matter what order I put these in, but maybe the next thing you might want to do is to plot the interest paid against the balance over time. All right, so we'll just define a method called plot balances, and it won't take any arguments because we'll just use some of these class variables in there. All right, so I will define a local variable though, and I'll set it equal to that amortization table. Okay, once I do that, I'm just going to go ahead and plot. Whoops. Okay, and we'll give it a label, and then I will also plot the cumulative sum of the interest. Put some grid lines in there. Okay, we'll put the legend on there. and we will show it. Okay, so we can test that out if we want. Okay, and so there's our loan. All right, and so you can modify that to make it look however you want, but at least that gets us started. All right, and we can see that, okay, we pay it off in 2052 based on the inputs we gave it. Close that. Just comment that out. I don't need to look at that every time I run this. Moving on to our next method. All right, we will define our summary. Again, we don't need any arguments here. We do need it to be aligned properly, though. Okay, that looks better. And so here I'm just going to format a bunch of strings as a summary. And I just chose the monthly payment, the date that you pay off the loan, and then the total interest. Obviously, we could include other things in the summary, but that's what I've chosen. All right, so it's just a bunch of formatting of strings here. Okay, so here's where I'm going to use that formatted string that I made when I was making the initializer. Just right align that. And we're going to need to actually get a copy of that pandas data frame in here. So just get the last value out of the index there, and we'll get the date of it. Okay, and then finally we'll print off the cumulative interest that we paid over the life of the loan. Can get the last value there. Obviously, ahead of time, played around a little bit with the formatting here, so hopefully this will get us something pretty close, and then we'll just repeat this. Okay, obviously we could alternatively, return this as probably something like a doc string if you don't want to use a bunch of print statements. Sorry, but this is just the way I did it. And so down here, right, all we need to do then is we don't need to print anymore. We just call summary on it. Okay, let's test that out. Okay, so pretty good. The formatting, obviously, it looks like it needs to be modified here a little bit. All right, let me get a little more space there. So maybe right align that date, push that over, and maybe take a space away from the interest. And then that should be pretty good for a wide variety of total interests. All right, and let's see. Just push this over a bunch, and let's see how that works. All right, so almost, right? Obviously, I don't want the colon there. I want it here, and let's see if that fixes it. Okay, so pretty good. All right, so as I said, if you want more stuff in your summary, you are welcome to add that there. All right, but I'm going to stop there. All right, in the interest of time, and we're going to move on to our next method, which is going to tell us how many years it'll take to pay off if we pay a little bit extra every month. All right, so I'll just call this method extra payment, and here I'm going to have to pass something in, and that's the extra amount that we want to apply. Okay, and then this is pretty simple. All I need is a return here. We're going to use our friend NumPy Financial and the NPER function inside there and pass in the required arguments here. Oh, it's the term we're trying to solve for, so I can't do that. Self payment. And that extra amount, loan amount. Okay, and if we want it expressed as years, we will divide that by 12. Let me get rid of some of the decimals as well in case there's extra there. We'll round this. Okay, and then let's try that. So we'll print that off. And we'll just give an extra $100 a month there. Okay, it's not going to impact the summary, so we'd have to add some functionality if we wanted that to happen. But I'll leave it up to you to do that. All right, so there it is. And again, it didn't round it. I'm not sure why it's not doing that. I guess I can put the whole thing. I can force it a little bit here. We'll round it here. All right, see if that works better. Okay, so there it is. All right, cutting off 3 1/3 years by adding an extra $100 a month to your payment. Okay, so then the last method I'm going to write is, rather than, checking a whole bunch of extra payment amounts to get to a payoff period that we want, I'm going to write a function that asks us to input how many years we want to be able to pay the loan off in, and then it returns the amount of the extra payment that we need to add every month. Okay, so I'll just call this one retire debt. And, all right, we'll pass in years to pay off. And if you want, you could pass in, set a default value here, something maybe like 10 years. All right, I'm going to leave it and require you to actually type that in. Okay, and then we're going to start an extra payment here. All right, I'm going to set it at $1. All right, so this is going to get us, how much do we have to pay extra every month within $1 to pay it off in some specified number of years, okay? And then all I need to do is loop through the NumPy Financial N per until I get to that years to pay off. Okay, this is going to happen pretty fast, but, you know, if it's too precise, you can obviously, you know, change that to 5 or something like that and increment it by 5s. All right, and then you'd be within $5. All right, once we get there, all we need to do is sort of return, right? And you can return whatever you want here. You could maybe return a tuple of values. All right, I'm just going to return the extra payment. All right, but all right, maybe we can return the loan payment with that added in, so nobody has to do that math. All right, let's try that out. So that one's going to be retire, and obviously we don't want it to be 100 years. Let's try 10. Okay, run it. Okay, so in order to pay it off in 10 years, we have to add $1,845 each month, right, for a total of 39, we'll call it 75. Okay, so I'm going to make the code available, like I said, and hopefully that helps you make a loan analyzing class.